I think for me, my dreams and goals, they bounce everywhere and then some. You know, I do one thing and then I think that's the top and then I change it. And I think the biggest thing I've learned about goal setting too is, you know, it's good to set goals, but what do you do when you reach them? Where do you go from there? And there's some people that are totally fine with it. They're like, you know, I reached that goal, I'm happy, I'm content, that's great. And there's other people who they reach a goal and they're not satisfied yet. They still want more. And I think for me, that's the biggest thing I've pushed myself to do is, you know, not be content once I reach a goal. You know, be happy and be proud of myself, but always strive for more so I don't get in this, you know, spot where, you know, now what's next? And, you know, it started when I made the national team and then I broke my first American record and I broke my first world record. And it was, you know, yeah, they were cool, but I always wanted more. And so I think for me, from the performance component, my gold medal in London was amazing, but I want more. You know, I went into London looking at 9 gold medals in 9 events. And, you know, I was in a position to do it. And then I was reclassified and it all went away. And that was a really hard pill to swallow. And so I feel like, although that 50 freestyle, considering the situation, was, you know, a race of a lifetime, I know there's so much more that I'm capable of. And, you know, I want to use these 4 years and go into Rio and kind of, you know, make my mark and prove to myself what I can do. And, you know, outside of the pool, I want to write a book. You know, I want to work on Capitol Hill and hopefully change laws around medical malpractice so things that happen to me don't happen to someone else down the line. I want to conquer the world, but I actually do. You know, I have a tattoo, which you'll see, that says, "You're the best, you can make a difference, you can change the world." And it's a phrase that my dad told me and my sisters when we were growing up. He tucked us into bed every night, said our prayers, and told us, "You're the best, you can make a difference, and you can change the world." And after I was paralyzed, I got tattooed on my rib cage, and I try to live my life by those words. You know, my dad's biased. I'm the baby of 3 girls. Of course, I'm the best. Like, that's my dad. Those are his thoughts on me. But making a difference and changing the world, I think, is something that all of us can do in our everyday life. And so I think, you know, that just like broad spectrum is a goal and dream of mine. And the list grows every day. You know, there's the little things of, I'm going to dive again for the first time, or I learned how to ski this winter for the first time, or I want to learn how to surf. And, you know, it's just kind of the ongoing list of little things that I want to do. And then there's the big picture. So I think it's ever evolving, but there's definitely a lot in it.